You put it out, believe her.
I don't believe her.
I would assume he materialized upstairs or something of that effect.
But my kids, how will they?
Their father loves them. We'll get them through.
That's not the point. If we're dead, then I'm never going to see them again. And as it is, I haven't seen them much since my husband was laid off and I went back to work. I've missed the past 4 years of their lives, and now I'm going to miss the rest.
I'm sure they know you love them.
But I haven't been there for them. What kind of parent have I been?
Ah, we've passed Nile and now we're in the fields. Wake me when the next train comes.
You did your best to provide for them. You've done nothing wrong.
Your family needed money to get by. You took care of that, I assume. But you did it honorably.
Don't get it, do you? You must not have kids.
I have a son. He's an engineering major in college. He's a good man. My wife, we're very proud.
Two daughters, both in high school. Sister, I have a confession to make.
What is it, son?
I don't go to church often, but... I've done something terribly wrong.
What are you doing?
If I'm dead, I'd like to keep my sins off my chest.
No, I'm not Catholic, but isn't that something you do before you die?
Given the circumstances, it's better late than never.
No! Don't do it.
What now?
You don't want to go there. It only makes this place worse. Excuse me, son. One moment. Dearie, tell me what's bothering you.
What's her problem? Something must be troubling.
Probably withholding more information from us. She obviously knows more about this.
Why must everyone be a hostile witness to you?
How old do you think she is?
Early 20s, I'd say.
Poor parents. No one deserves to see their children die before them.
I can't just leave my mom stuck in the mud like that.
But if I'm home late, my father will kill me. And then he'll kill you.
No. It's not fair.
I should be waiting with my... How the tow truck gonna get down there in this one? I should be waiting with my car.
Once you take me home, you can go back then. And I'm sorry that my parents have a stricter curfew than yours do. At least it's not raining here.
They don't deserve to be here this young.
But they are here. Should we tell them where here is?
They may be better off not knowing.
Are you serious? They deserve to know as much as we do.
She won't say much about this place. But I think I've got to calm down. I see we have new arrivals.
We're debating whether or not to share a video with them.
They will learn when the time is right.
This guy, does it seem like everybody's watching us? Or am I just paranoid?
I think they are watching us. Excuse me, can you tell me when the next train comes? Is there something we can help you with, dear?
No. Just trying to get out.
Yes, sister. My boyfriend and I got a little car trouble. Embarrassing story, really. But I have to get home soon. Can you tell me when the next train will get to... What's the closest station to my house?
I don't know. I don't think there is one.
There has to be one. Why else would we have come down here?
Have we ever been on a subway before? I mean, is there one near our town? Let alone near us in Indiana?
You have a point. Sister, can you tell me which way this train goes? Which way? Which way?
Now that's an important inquiry.
Okay. We were going to get on the train without knowing where it's going?
You don't know where it's going?
Well, it's a little complicated.
A little complicated? That train's our only way out of here. And we don't even know where it goes. Our only way out.
As I see it, theology tells us there are only two places this train could be taken.
And what are they, smart guy?
Accepting our condition for what we think it is. The train either goes up or down.
Up or down? What does that mean?
It's nothing. Ignore what I'm saying.
Up, or down.
What a crappy way to end the night. First, we're stuck. First, the car rolls down the hill, and now we're stuck with you, wackos.
home. This can't be easy on them.
Sorry, but you must know the underage drinking statistics.
All I wanted was to get my girlfriend. All I wanted was to take my girlfriend out for dinner for our anniversary and then overlook the town afterwards. I didn't plan on my car sliding down a hill and crashing.
Your anniversary? I was supposed to. You're very right in your age, and you seem to be handling the news better than some of the adults.
Thanks, I guess.
Baby, if we're, you know, is everyone else?
Probably. So, what happens next?
Excuse me?
The train. Which way is it going? Up or down?
We haven't determined yet. How ironic, when I assigned Dante's Divine Comedy to my students last semester, I never thought I'd soon experience it.
There's no clues anywhere. Not any of the walls. How are we supposed to know?
That's what she's not telling us. You know what's been trained on us.
No.
You're withholding information again. You know what's been trained on us, and that's why you haven't gotten on yet.
You mean she knows it's going to hell, so she's not getting on?
Clear case to me.
Sister, I have to get my confession out.
Go ahead, son.
Oh. Yeah. Going to? Down there?
No, I don't know which way it goes.
Sister, I have to make my confession now.
Go ahead, son.
I work for the insurance company. I work for an insurance company in the accounting department. I know what you're gonna say. The industry is known for ripping people off. That being said, I found an error of $25,000 in my company's favor. I told my boss, but he didn't want to hear it, so he brushed me off. I figured if the company didn't want to acknowledge it, then, well, you see, my daughter starts college in a year, and tuition being what it is.
You embezzled it.
I wired it back to my account. A couple days passed, and no one seemed to notice.
Thou shalt not steal. Even I know it's commandment, not just the law.
But I wired it back this morning. I felt awful. I felt dirty, like a criminal.
I hate to break it to you, but what you did qualifies you as one.
But I gave it back. I gave the money back.
It's still a crime.
I explained to how you treated us all like criminals.
So what happened, Professor?
Well, you see,
you had an affair in here
with one of my students. She was a graduate, a consenting adult.
That doesn't make it right.
I understand that, but my marriage hasn't exactly been working out for a while. After my son left for college, my wife and I grew more and more distant. And then there was this girl.
And your wife found out.
For all we know, she could have killed him and sent him here.
I understand what I did was wrong, but it wasn't a crime. Don't I deserve some happiness?
You complete the unholy trinity. Stealing, killing, and now adultery.
Oh, we're so screwed.
A moment ago, you were convinced that we're all going to heaven. Not so convinced now. What are you hiding?
We shall let the Lord and not each other judge our actions.
I'll admit I made a major transgression, but otherwise, I'm a good person.
We get it. You were dedicated to your son, your job, your students. A little too dedicated to one of them.
Those who live in glass houses shall not throw stones. Why don't you share your history with us?
It's no one else's business.
Cleaning the fifth, I see. Are you afraid it's your presence here that sends the rest of us to
hell?